You kind of have the comic relief part of this. Do you view it that way?
I totally view it that way. Yeah, yeah.
Was that fun to be the more light character in this, if you would?
It is. And I mean, I think that they'd searched around for this character for a long time in the casting, and you know, hadn't necessarily noticed that the character had that potential. And I think that the fact that I played her as someone who actually kind of enjoyed what she did for a living.
Well, talk about enjoying what you do for a living. How did you get into this character?
Well, did you notice that I just turned a little bit pinker? I actually did, believe it or not, do something in the form of research. It wasn't so much research as it was I had to get myself over the hump a little bit in terms of feeling self-conscious.
Yeah.
You know, sort of strutting around and being sexual and all of that in front of people. And I knew that that would be something of a challenge for me. So I went and took, Sheila Kelly has this class called the S Factor, which is a class in pole dancing. And of course, that's nothing like, well, yes, it's nothing like what this character does, because it's sort of more, you know, it's in the 40s, so there's fan dancing in it, and it's much more sort of demure as the style of dancing of that period was. But it helped me get into the mode of sort of strutting my stuff without feeling ashamed, you know, which is, you know.
How much fun was it strutting your stuff in front of George Clooney?
You know, I would forget, you know, that I was all dolled up with a platinum wig and wearing spangles and all of that, whatever else I was doing. And you know, how do I put this? Is I'm not used to being responded to like that kind of character would be responded to.
Like during lunch, you would go out and eat like this and people would go, woohoo!
Out in the pub. No, but I'm saying I felt like within the context of our little work group, that there was a kind of, let's just say, flirty energy going around or something like that, that I was really enjoying bathing in for a while, and it was sort of sad to me that I had to let her go and return to my drab self afterwards, because she's a girl who could have fun, you know? And I thought,
so this is the role you're going to be searching for from now on in film.
Yes, bring on the bimbos, you know, why not?
Getting onto a serious subject, why do audiences accept black and white films and film noir now? It seems to be so back in vogue.
Well, I think that, do you want my honest, it's sort of a very, you know, I think that we're in very confused times right now, you know, where our identity as a nation is confused, where, you know, we feel very in the dark. And I think there's something comforting about going back, you know, where we sort of knew who we were and, you know, who was the good guy and who was the bad guy, or we thought we knew that. I think one of the interesting things this movie does is it turns that around a little bit. Where, you know, if there was any era where we were sure the Americans were on the right side, it was the Second World War, because by God, we were fighting the Nazis. You know what I mean? And even that is brought into some kind of, at least some aspects of our role in it were not necessarily above board, and that's part of what's going on here too. So, you know, it's a modern take on something that, because of its style, is comfortable and familiar, but the subtext of it is really not so familiar. Do you know what I mean? So it does this very interesting trick on the audience, and some people will see it that way and some people won't.